Gestalt therapy is working on an equation. Awareness equal present time equal reality. In contrast with psychology, we try to get hold of the obvious, of the surface, of the situation in which we find ourselves, and to develop the emerging gestalt strictly on the I and thou, here and now basis. Any escape into the future or the past is examined as a likely resistance against the ongoing encounter. Modern man has alienated, given up so much of his potential that his ability to cope with his existence becomes badly impoverished. My aim is this. The patient should recover his lost potential. He should integrate the conflicting polarities, understand the difference between game playing, especially the playing of verbal games, on the one hand, and of genuine, authentic, confident behavior on the other. The civil war of inner conflicts weakens the efficiency in compassion, but every bit of integration will strengthen it. Now, in the safe emergency of the therapeutic situation, I repeat, in the safe emergency of the therapeutic situation, the patient begins to take risks and to transform his energies from manipulating the environment for support into developing greater and greater self-support, that is, reliance on his own resources. This process is called maturation. Once the patient has learned to stand on his own feet, emotionally, intellectually, and economically, his need for therapy will collapse. He will wake up from the nightmare of his existence. The basic technique is this. Not to explain things to the patient, but to provide the patient with opportunities to understand and to discover himself. For this purpose, I manipulate and frustrate the patient in such a way that he's confronting himself. In this process, he identifies with his lost potential, for instance, through assimilating his projections by acting out the alien parts of himself. Principally, I consider any interpretation to be a therapeutic mistake, as this would imply that the therapist understands the patient better than the patient himself. Takes away from the patient the chance of discovering himself by himself, and prevents him from finding out his own values and style. On the other hand, I disregard most of the content of what the patient says and concentrate most on the non-verbal level, as this is the only one which is less subject to self-deception than his verbal pseudo-self-expression. On the non-verbal level, the relevant gestalt will always emerge and can be dealt with in the here and now.
Tired of not getting the results you want? Relax and leave the rest to us.